One of another most important aspects of this laptop repair business is customer satisfaction. See, customer satisfaction is also very important. If a customer is satisfied, only then he will come to you again. Otherwise, if he is not satisfied, maybe he won't say anything to you, but he will never come back to your shop and not recommend this to anybody else to get his laptop repaired from you. To acquire customer satisfaction, first of all, work on the customer's equipment thoroughly, get into the root cause of the equipment, of the error, and then work seriously and thoroughly on that error. So, and make sure that this error doesn't arise again. To check this, you have to keep the laptop or the customer's equipment running for 2 to 3 hours under full load to check whether the laptop has been repaired properly. If there is some weak point, it will get arised after some time. So after doing a repair job, quality testing and testing of the equipment is very important. So after that, give the equipment to the customer, and in this way you can acquire customer satisfaction. And if the customer is satisfied, he will himself tell his family and friends to that there is a good repairer in our city, so you can get your laptop repaired from that person. See, this customer satisfaction, I will give you an example. See, customer, you got a laptop and the customer was saying that the laptop is shutting down. The laptop is shutting down after 5 minutes or 10 minutes or when I start playing games, the laptop turns off immediately. No lights, no life after that. And after that, the laptop takes some time to get powered on again. So this is a case of servicing the laptop. Maybe the vents of the fan, the output vents from where the air comes out, it is blocked. Alright, so you can tell the customer that this repair will take 1 to 2 hours, or maybe in the evening, not longer than 4 hours. See, servicing a laptop takes 1 hour only. But if you have got loads of work, so you can tell the customer that today I am unable to do this repair. Maybe you can come tomorrow, or you keep the laptop at your place and ask the customer to collect it the next day. After finishing this work, keep the laptop running under full load. Full load means open a game along with some video and songs running parallel to each other so that the processor and the graphics card gets maximum load, and at the same time monitor the temperature with some temperature monitoring utility like Open Hardware Monitor or some other utilities. These are available free on the Google's page. Monitor the temperature. It may not pass beyond 60 degrees. If there is a NVIDIA or ATI chipset, the temperature may not pass beyond 65 to 70 degrees. And if it is an Intel chipset without NVIDIA or ATI graphics card, then the temperature should not go beyond 50-55 degrees. If it is going past 60 in Intel chipsets, then you have to check again that whether the fan is functioning properly, it is spinning freely, or in ATIs, if it is going beyond 80 degrees, and NVIDIA chipsets, if it is getting beyond 80 degrees, you have to check the same thing. The connection, physical connection of the heatsink and the chip, is it proper? Is the thermal pad, the pad which you place underneath this, it is proper? Only then, after checking all these necessary things, you should hand the laptop back to the customer, and do give a proper warranty after giving the service. Give a 30 days or 60 days warranties, whatever suits you. Don't charge the customer again if he comes back in warranty period, not even for your service. If there is some another part failing, like say you have done the service of this laptop tell the customer that I have done the service, and after a week customer returns back and he says that the laptop is again getting hot. Again, check the laptop in front of the customer. See, if you get a failed fan at that time, tell the customer that earlier I have cleaned the laptop, I have serviced the laptop only. This fan is a separate issue. This has got a physical damage. Maybe the spindle is damaged or the coil has burnt. So this fan requires a replacement. At that time, you may not charge the customer for service charges, for labor charges, but you should charge for the cost of this spare part, the fan. All right, the customer will be satisfied. This is a separate issue if the fan has failed. Gaining the customer satisfaction and customer delight is very important in this business.